Welcome back to Media Weekly. Today I have not only one but two experts I'll be talking to today about stop motion and all sorts of media. Please welcome Harley Humphreys and John Harrison.
Hi, how are you going? It's a pleasure to be here, thanks so much.
So can you tell me about a couple of pioneers then, please?
Of course. Let's start with Joseph Plateau.
Well, so first of all, Plateau was a physicist, a Belgian physicist, and he was thought to be the first one to create moving image, like the illusion of moving image. And so in 1829, Joseph Plateau, he came up with this idea that he could advance moving image, and so he came up with this device that he called the phonetoscope. But of course, it wasn't until 1833 that he started working on his invention, and it wasn't until 1841 that the phonetoscope was born. Well, as you can see, there's a video up here of the phonetoscope in action. And what you can see is it's a machine that has that's a disc and has several images drawn around it. And so this disc would fit inside the machine. And when you turned a handle, the disc would rotate and the images would move fast enough so that they would blur together to, you know, give the illusion of moving image. So that's the video of it. And of course, Plateau, he was thrilled with this. He loved it. He, you know, nobody had ever done this before, at least not to his knowledge.
So yeah, he was really proud of it.
That's good. So what other developers can you tell me about?
Well, have you heard of Emile Renau?
Yeah, of course.
Well, let me tell you about him.
So Charles Emile Renau was a French animator, and he'd made a lot of different animations. For example, in his 30s, around the 1870s, he made a lot of short animations. And he made it with his own, well, a rather famous invention, his own invention, the prestentoscope. It was very similar to the zoetrope, actually, which was created by William Horner. It would have a wheel of images on it, and you would fit it inside the machine, obviously. It was a strip of paper. And you would turn it around, and these images would blur together to create a short production. And then later on in his career, in the 1880s and 1890s, he went on to make short animations that were really successful. So here's another developer that is, you know, pretty influential in the animation.
It's very interesting.
And do you know any developers?
Of course I do.
So the developer, Jan Švankmajer, is a Czech filmmaker and artist, currently 80 years old and still going on strong. He was a developer of surrealism. And he brought the surrealist sort of animation into the mainstream. For an example, some of his films are simply titled Alice and Little Otik. So in 2000, Little Otik came out, and it was a very unnerving, very creepy film. And it was about this woman who'd lost her son. So she gets a log and carves out a baby from it, which is really creepy. And basically the story really starts to take a turn as this log sort of turns into a real thing. And very unnerving, something that everyone should watch, so go check that out. So Han has won, he's won many awards over his life. One of his most recent awards was the FIAF, which he won actually this year, July 10th, 2014. He's definitely, you should check him out. Everyone at home, go check him out.
So, John, can you tell me about any contemporary animators?
Yeah, I can tell you about a few. The first one that I found quite interesting is the Brothers Clay. They were a pair of American twins who took most of their inspiration from Wallace and Gromit, who Harley's just talked to us about.
Yeah.
And most of their films are about Eastern Europe culture. Then they have a unique film style they'll call Avant Grande. You might have heard of it if you use Wikipedia. They consider themselves great animators and filmmakers, and they are both 67 and still alive in America. They love to create films that the critics would often call surreal or disturbing, which is a take on most of their animations. Their storyline is a little odd, and they are prone to be quite dark.
And do you know any more?
I tell you a bit about From the Crows Arrival, if you've heard of her. She was an Irish filmmaker who is based in London at the moment. She's most famous for her films The Case of Regina Scalzi and Head Over Heels. Mm-hmm. Well, she actually won an Oscar and was an ex-Henley College student.
Oh, wow. Oh, gosh, I know Henley.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Too much.
Well, that's very interesting. So what else can you tell me about animation in general?
Well,
stop motion and all that.
Yeah, well, animation has grown tremendously over the years. In the 90s and early 2000s, animation was mostly popular on kids' channels because people finally make it more professional, like programs like Morph, SpongeBob, Wallace and Gromit. So hardly was it on televisions. It was very popular in music videos as well. Artists like to do things differently, and animation has been growing huge in the last 20 years. And it seemed like a usual thing to do, and people still make animated music videos to this day. Some very well-known animated music videos would be Peter Gabriel's Sledgehammer. Feel Good by the Gorrilaz. I'm stepping in harder this year. Yeah, bear rapping in harder this year. Watch me as I gravitate. Ha, 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 ha. We got Ghost Town, it's Motown with Joe Sound, you in the blink. And Leave Me Alone by Michael Jackson.
TV animation is one very interesting subject. What about cinema? What's animation grown?
Cinema's grown a lot over the years as well. So many companies which are widely recognised over the world, such as Tim Burton, who released A Nightmare Before Christmas, which is a massively popular film in modern culture, which is seen more frequent in cinemas. Some examples of famous animated movies could be Wallace and Gromit, Curse of the Ware Rabbit, by Aardman Animations. Spirited Away by Studio Ghibli.
What? They're all for me? Thanks, but I don't need any more. No, I only need one.
And Toy Story by Disney and Pixar.
And you, my friend, are responsible for delaying my rendezvous with Star Command. You are a toy! You weren't the real Buzz Lightyear. You're an action figure. You are a child's plaything. You are a sad, strange little man, and you have my pity.
Well, it has been a real pleasure to have you both on.
Well, it's been a
Everyone,
pleasure to meet
you. Round of applause for Harley Humphreys and John Harrison.
Thank you.